please stand if you are able for the call to worship as we read responsively? How lovely to worship and sing your praise. How lovely, Lord. How lovely to live as your people on earth.
How lovely, Lord. How lovely to be strengthened and blessed by your grace.
Please remain standing for the hymn.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord, you give life, you are love, you bring light in the dark. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you, Lord. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. And all the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, and his bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. And all the earth will shout our praise. Our hearts will cry, and his bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. Pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. To you only. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord.
like to thank Mr. Fred for singing with us today. Thank you, Jen. Let's have the kids come forward. Our friends are outside. They're going to come inside and sit on the mats as we move into our time of children's time. Thank you, gentlemen, for coming in. I know all the cool coloring books and twisty sticks are outside, so I'll get you back to them very quick. But I want to share with you a minute in the children's message what my sermon's going to be about. When I went to college, I studied performing arts. So I had to take some music classes, some acting classes. Can you keep a secret? I took ballet. And I took tap dancing. Ask Mrs. Davis, look at her. Did I take ballet in college? I can still do it. I'll show you later. I had all these wonderful classes that I took, and they helped me experience everything it takes to be a part of a play or a musical or everything, including stagecraft. And stagecraft was my favorite class. Do you know what stagecraft is? It's when you learn how to use tools to make sets and backgrounds and how to paint things for staging and such. And the first lesson my teacher taught us is to use the tools for their right reasons. And there's some tools that are made to construct things, and there's some tools that are made to tear them down. So like a crowbar, what do you think? You know what a crowbar is, right? Do you think a crowbar is a creating tool or a destroying tool? It tears the sets apart. You put the crowbar in there and you pry it apart. What about a screwdriver? Is that a preparing tool or a tearing apart tool? A preparing tool, because you got to screw it in. Okay, what about this? What about a hammer? It's both, because one side you prepare it and you turn around, and the other side you take it apart. But I learned very quickly in stagecraft, if you use a tool for a reason it's not used, you might get hurt. Because one day I was taking a sets apart and I used a screwdriver as a taking apart tool, and I cut my thumb apart. And it hurt so bad because I used a tool for a reason it wasn't made for. Today we're going to look at Ephesians and the armor of God. And we're going to learn about all the tools that God gives us to help other people and to care for ourselves. And one of the things that we need to remember, when we use the tools that God gives us, there's a reason that God gave them to us. And if we use them wrong, sometimes we get hurt, and sometimes, unfortunately, we hurt other people. So we need to remember that all of God's tools are creating tools. They are there to create hope and love and joy and peace so that we can create a family in God's love. Okay? So let's all remember to use God's tools in the name of grace and care. Okay? Let's join together in prayer. Dear God, thank you for loving me and helping me care for others. Amen. Okay, thank you guys. And as we continue to learn about all of our members and friends of the church, I'd like to ask Mr. Paul Tillery to come forward as we continue to learn about the different parts of our body that is North Coast United Methodist Church.
Good morning. Today I'm here to tell you how I came to North Coast Methodist. I had to ask Les how long I'd been here because I couldn't remember. And he came up with the number 10, so we'll just stick with number 10. So for 10 years I've been here. It's been a real joy. When I first came here, I was fascinated by how everybody knew each other and loved each other and cared for each other. And I knew this was probably the place for me. And I found this church. My wife and I were driving through the neighborhood, and I saw the church, and we stopped. I got out and walked around, and I felt really good about how everything was there. And so I decided that I would call the pastor, Pastor Harris that time. And she invited me to join the church, and I did. And it's been great ever since. I went to Stephen Ministry School and graduated from there. It's been about 3 years now. I've had one long time assignment, which was great. And I'm also on the visitation committee. And I also do whatever anybody asks me to do as best I can. You know, if I can't do, I'll find out who can. The one thing I want everybody to know here is that I love all of you. And it's great to be able to come here on Sundays and be with you. And I just wanted to take a minute to read three verses out of Matthew. And hopefully when you're not feeling well, this will help pick you up. And I'm going to start out with verse 28. Come to me, all who are labored and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest in your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So if you remember that, that should give you a little bit of inspiration, because God's there and he's always going to wait on you. And so I'm hoping that your days at this church will be as wonderful as mine has been so far. And thank you for your time.
Please be in an attitude of prayer. Holy One of mystery and power, fill our lives with your glory as you filled the temple with clouds when Solomon first brought the ark into your holy dwelling place. Give us the strength and the power to withstand the forces of death and destruction at work in our lives and in our world. Amen. Join me now in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me.
God, fall afresh on me.
Let's join together in a time of prayer as we pray our prayer of assurance. The Lord God is our sun and shield. Trust in the Lord and receive God's blessings. Amen.
This morning's scripture is found in the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 10 through 20. The armor of God. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put the full armor of God on so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Pray also for me that whenever I speak, words may be given to me that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should. This is the word of God.
Make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, where there is death, where there is
Let's join together in prayer. Precious and loving God, we thank you for being our precious and loving God, reminding us, even in places that we may feel conflict, that you came to be the beacon of peace. Today, as we look at the armor in which that you gave us, help us see the tools to construct love. Be with us today, God. Guide these words. Amen. Thank you all for being here today. And my friends outside, thank you for being here today. And my friends at home watching on Zoom and YouTube, thank you for being here today. As we continue to try to use all of our tools to care for each other, it is worth the work and the effort to give as many opportunities for you to experience God's grace as possible. Thank you all for being here. And I want us to look at this scripture, and my mind went to so many different places as I began to do my personal devotional work this week to share this sermon with you. The first took me back to a very younger age when I looked forward to Sunday school, specifically the weekend that we had the armor of God as our lesson plan. Normally, it always came along with it craft time. And I and the other young men in the room, young rambunctious boys in the room, look forward to making our swords and our shields during this lesson so that as our teacher tried to describe how that they were implements of God's love, we could play Roman soldiers and hit each other with everything. The excitement and the joy that came from having this moment of making something to go into a world of imagination. And sometimes, as we tend to do, we see the tools before us in one way, but they're actually meant for something else. Just like a young Drew Davis hitting his best friend Brian McGuire with a paper sword. Here we are one day, years later, looking at these tools not as implements of destruction, as I shared in our children's lesson today, but what they were really meant to be is instruments of care and guidance and comfort so that everyone could begin to see the presence of grace in their lives. It was a blessing to be reminded this week of this song of the prayer of St. Francis Paul. I too went through Stephen ministry as a Stephen's leader at my previous church. And at the end of each week's meetings, as we talked about how we go out to provide care for other people, we would share the prayer of St. Francis at the end of our meetings. And the beautiful thing about this prayer of St. Francis is a reminder I want to give you about the armor of God. There is so much hurt and worry and concern that we have to deal with. But as long as we find ways for God to make us instruments of his peace, and where there is hatred, let us sow love, and where there is injury, healing, and where there is hurt, pardon, we become to be the images of grace that God calls us to be. The challenge within all of that is we are human beings, and sometimes someone unintentionally steps on our toes. Sometimes someone unintentionally says something that hurts our feelings, and we all digress into our reactionary states, and we want to respond. And that response is where things get a little bit messy. Because it's when that we start to respond, the most hurt comes. If you watch football, and I've shared this with many teenage boys through the youth programs that I've worked with, if you ever see someone get a penalty in a football game, it's quite commonly the person that responds to what someone else did in a play. The challenge of not being responsive people, but being prayerful, reflective people, being willing, even when we are in moments of hurting and pain, to share love, pardon, and healing. I want you to take a moment to think about the tools that we have in our lives. And God has blessed us with so many tools. Jen and Fred, the tools of music, that they come in here and they help the Holy Spirit flow through the usage of music and songs and melodies. I think about individuals, and I keep seeing the Marvel mask. I think about the tools that Stan Lee had. And Stan Lee told so many different stories that taught young kids how to interact with disabilities and differences. If you listen to the stories of the X-Men are individuals that have something that set them apart from the everyday, and they are challenged to make those tools to make things better. We all deal with those things. We may not be mutants in a science fiction story, but we have things that set us apart. And those beautiful things become the tools that we can use to bless other people. As I look around the room and I look at the things that are in this room, Miss Lorraine Weiss made these beautiful mats one day as a blessing of one of the gifts and tools that she has. When she decided to use that gift and tool, little did she know that one day they would be implements of a tool of care for our young children, so that when they come forward in our worship service, they can hear the children's message painfully from their pastor, but they can have something comfortable to sit on, not just to be a comfortable place on the floor, but to remind them of the social distancing that they need in this period of living, so that they're taking care of each other. I think about Les and Crystal and all of the, Larry, all the dear friends that stand in our entranceway who have these gifts of being individual, welcoming spirits that when we have new friends walk through the door, they say hi with a smiling face that you can't see right now because of the mask, but they're taking care of you and smiling anyway. And one of them has the ability to catch my eye and say, come here and say hi. Enabling us to use our tools, our welcoming spirit, to move out and to help individuals know that when we live in a world that is filled with hate and hurting and worry, this is the welcoming environment that you can sit in for an hour and find peace, comfort, and care. That's when we begin to differentiate our gifts, because if you watch the news, we can show all of the examples of how individuals take tools that should be used to create something, but unfortunately use them to disrepair things. We are called within our faith to be the difference that exists in the world. We're called in our faith to intentionally go out and stand out as a light of hope within a darkness that sometimes feels extraordinarily dark. And we are called the ones to be so radically different that hopefully that we inspire people to ask the question, why are you different? And then we respond back, because Jesus Christ makes me different. I want you for a moment to think about the tools that exist in your lives. I want you to think about the tools that you have that gives you peace and you joy. It could be the making of mats. It could be these beautiful shawls that our shawl team makes and they send out as prayer reminders that individuals are being prayed for in very unique moments of living. It could be someone that likes to talk on the phone and through the guidance of MJ, making a phone call at the right minute, at the right time, just to tell someone, hello, I remember you. And then they feel special because they know that this community is holding them in their hearts. It's all these ways that these tools of construction build hope. And the more times we build hope and the more ways we deal hope, the more opportunities individuals have a chance to sit in hope. And they can feel the love that gives them the encouragement to go on one more day. I'm going to embarrass myself for a moment. I'm going to use one of the things that gives me hope to give you an analogy of what I fully see within the scripture of the armor of God, because there's so much in our lives that we see as combative. I already shared with you, when I was a young child, I saw the sword and the shield, and I whacked my buddy in the shoulder over and over again in class until the Sunday school teacher had to get my grandma to come get me. But those are tools of love and care. So last night, the oldest and I were watching SummerSlam on pay-per-view, the wrestling. And I was thinking about professional wrestling for a moment in this narrative. So bear with me. I already see you cringing because I'm going to use this analogy. But I want you to specifically think about professional wrestling as I talk about how these tools that appear to be destructive are actually things that provide care. In this scripted world of violence, in this scripted world of pre-prepared endings, exists an environment that people can really be harmed. And so many dear people have broken arms, and one dear friend died because of participating in this scripted world. The goal within this scripted world of violence is to be two individuals that are in a place telling a story, but they are still taking care of each other in the process. They may be telling a story of hurt and pain. They may be telling a story of conflict, but the overall goal and the reality of it all is, as they tell that story, their main responsibility is to take care of each other in the process. I want us to think about that within our reality. Because we go out and we participate in stories of hurt and pain. And sometimes we step out in faith in places of conflict, and it's not our goal to go out and be combative. It's our goal to go out and care for each other. No matter how worrisome the conflict may seem, and no matter how dark the places may go, it's not our places to take the swords and the shields as weapons of destruction. It's our goal to take our swords and our shields, and just like the scripted fantasy world of wrestling that I love, even though that we are invisible conflict, we are actually trying to take care of each other within the story. Did that make sense? Did that work? Okay. Remember that, because that's our goal. I shared with you my experience in stagecraft class, where I cut my thumb using a screwdriver, instrument of creation, for a dismantling thing. And unfortunately, how much that hurt me. I've seen faith used in that exact same way. That we become so focused on something that we feel should be a set standard, and we forget that we are not here to harm other people with our standards. We are here to create hope, love, joy, and peace with our tool of creation and not our tool of dismantling. I want you to pray over that. Because we've been called to do some beautiful things. We have been called to be the image of Jesus Christ in the world. And never once did I see Jesus Christ tell someone to go away. I saw Jesus Christ work very hard to remind individuals that everyone has a place at the altar of grace. So, Miss Sandra, the next time that you teach this Sunday school lesson here, and the kids start whacking each other with their swords and their shields, just say, well, your pastor did that too, and eventually he kind of sort of grew up. But also remind them that even in our places of conflict, we are called to care for each other. And every tool is a tool of creation. Hold on to those things, and may the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen.
In gratitude for all we have received, accept our gifts and offerings, that we may abide in your love. Amen.
As we join in our time of communion, I share with you, in the United Methodist Church, we serve an open table. And the open table of the United Methodist Church shares that if this is your first time in a church ever, you're welcome here. If you have had a bad night the night before, you're welcome at this table. If you're searching for a place of love and acceptance, here it is. This table is for one and for all as we move into this time of celebration. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join in their unending hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith that Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Precious God, please pour out your Holy Spirit on us today and on these gifts of bread and cup. Make them be as your body and blood for us, as we celebrate your gifts now and forever. Amen. Please receive the gifts of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Let's all stand together. Thank you again for being here today, and let's join together in our closing benediction. Go forth with the strength of God. Go forth with the boldness of Christ. May the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen.
We'd like to have the opportunity to get to know you. Please email us at ncumcinfo@gmail.com. And if you've been enjoying our services online, please email us. Please say hello. Again, that's ncumcinfo@gmail.com. And also, if you'd like to give to our church, please go to northcoastumc.org and click on the Give button. Again, that's northcoastumc.org, and click on the Give button. Thank you for joining us.